On Thursday, Star Trek opened in theaters nationwide with an ad campaign that promised this isn't your father's Star Trek, a sentiment that upset some of the hardcore fan base of the franchise. Here to address those fans, the stars of the film, Chris Pine and Zachary Quinto.
Thank you, sir. Zach and I, thank you. Zachary and I wanted to come out tonight and address the longtime fans of Star Trek.
We understand that you're concerned about the way that we are handling your beloved franchise. Mm-hmm. But don't worry. We've gone to great lengths to ensure that this film fits in flawlessly with the established canon.
Absolutely. All the Star Trek stardates we use correspond perfectly with the ones used in the original series and in The Next Generation.
And our movie takes the time to explore the origins of the Kolinar ceremony as it is connected to the fascinating Ponfar marriage ritual.
And I swear that the transporters on this Enterprise utilize the Heisei... Oh, God, I have no idea what I'm talking about.
Neither do I. But you guys, seriously, please, you've got to stop harassing us. Mm-hmm.
You're getting harassed?
Yeah, you have no idea how insane some of these fans are, Seth.
Yeah, I'm getting angry. I'm getting angry calls in the middle of the night, Seth. I mean, at least I think they're angry. I can't really understand them. They're either speaking Vulcan or Hebrew.
And they keep vandalizing my mailbox every morning I wake up, and it's filled with decapitated action figures and empty inhaler canisters. Uh-huh.
And they're tying notes to rocks and throwing them against my windows. It's scratching the glass.
The rocks don't break through the windows?
No, they're clearly not throwing them hard enough.
I guess I'm just surprised you guys would be intimidated by Trekkies.
Yeah, well, they can be pretty intimidating, Seth. I mean, look.
Well, maybe, I mean, a little intimidating, maybe, you know?
We just really, we really hope they come out and see the movie, Seth.
They will come, they will come.
But Leonard, I mean, what if the fans reject Chris and me as the new Kirk and Spock?
Gentlemen, I've spent many years of my life among Trekkies, Trekkers, and they have been some of the greatest years of my life. And while it may take some time, I believe that soon they will find you, Chris, to be equal to the original Captain Kirk, and you, Zach, to be slightly less than equal to the original Spock. But ultimately, okay.
Okay. I mean, do you think that they're going to like the film?
Leonard? Well, to not like it...
Well, I know what you're going to say. To not like it would be illogical.
No, I was going to say to not like it would make them dickheads.